Hello, assalamu alaikum, كيف حالكم? This is Majid Said Naso Zahar Al Suleimany. I want to say some words, few words on this video concerning there's a lot of things that are happening around myself and around everything around this place. These places, okay. I just want to say some few words, and I hope people can listen to this video and hear it all at the same time. What I want to say is very simple. There is a Swahili saying, maneno mazuri amemtoa nyoka katika pango. Okay, translation, nice words have made the snake come out from its crevice, and the man said to the snake, I hear that you have very beautiful eyes, can I see your eyes? And the snake said, you think I'm stupid, you want me to come out from the crevice and then you're going to hit me and kill me? I said, oh no, I just want to see how beautiful eyes that you have. And the stupid snake decided to come out of the crevice, yani rock, and when the snake came out, it got hit on the head and was killed. Simple message. The theme of what I'm trying to say is this: communications are very important. You know, the people should not be taken for granted. Okay, there have been a lot of incidences recently concerning issues, mainly coming from PDO. About this 0.5% decrease given to pensioners. Okay, and there are two ways to look at this. There is one way to say, alhamdulillah, we got some breadcrumbs and some peanuts. Or the other side to say that we are disappointed and very much let down by this increase after a lot of big noise of we are pleased to announce you, and it makes people so excited that the good news is coming, and then they are laid down flat by a 0.5 increase. Okay, now my message is this. This same message could have been communicated from a high level to all the staff, saying, you all know the present circumstances and the situation prevailing in the country, and that a lot of people have actually lost their jobs. There are some people who are afraid of losing their jobs, and just to make our appreciation for the contribution that you have made towards the company and towards the nation, we are giving you not much increase in your salary, 0.5%, and when the situation will improve, we will try to give you requisite increment, something like that. You know, that message from a high level to all the pensioners and retirees could have done wonders, instead of the usual note coming from the patient section. I don't know who drafts these notes from there. I think it must be some foreigners got good English, or I don't know, God knows. Okay, and so anyway, there was a lot of talk, and there was a lot of people I know personally, because of me, I don't want to brag about myself, but I am a people's HR person. Okay, and a lot of people have been communicating to me about, especially from our lower level paid staff, interior staff pension of 400, and they get 2 years. The highest pay, let's go for the highest paid expatriate owner, sorry, of money, who's getting 4,000 real a month. He will get 20 reals, okay? Now, the guy who's getting 4,000 reals, if he gets 20 reals, he will help him with the petrol. But the guy who's getting 400 reals, the 2 reals, he cannot even buy, maybe he can buy only shawarma for that, or two or three, four pieces of mishkak, okay? People are grateful, do not misunderstand. People are grateful, they understand. but they need to be respected and people need to be appreciated, okay? And these things, I have noticed, you know, since the corona came, a lot of messages coming from, you know, from the pension section, from the medical people, and the way the messages are drafted, the way things are going, yeah, is not respecting the pensioners and the retirees who have actually contributed a lot to what PDO is today. The status of PDO is today is because of the contribution of these people. Okay, and when I say these people, that includes me also, because I worked for 25 years. I used to sleep in a porter cabin, and sometimes I used to keep my window open at night. A camel comes inside with his head inside the bedroom. Okay, and we fly sky vents to go to Fahud. It took us 2 hours in noisy sky vents. A lot of inconveniences. There was no security, there was no protection in the camp. The only things that were guarded were the installations, but not with the residents. There was nothing. Anybody could walk in and do any harm they wanted. Okay, this is what I want to say. Now, unfortunately, our brother, the chairman of the pensioners. He quickly went and thanked the management and said that all the pensioners are grateful for the increase and all these things. And maybe he was speaking for himself, but not for the lower-end paid pensioners. Okay, and this caused a lot of beef. You know, people really, really mad, really, really upset. Because, okay. And some of them, they approached me. They wanted me to stand up and to fight for this position. Okay, and they did not know how to do it. So I gave them some ideas how to do it. And so one of the ideas was to make a petition, and people to sign online. Okay, and unfortunately, the petition failed miserably. There were only 7 people who signed online. Then we came with an idea with the people who were approaching me, that we send a WhatsApp message to me, and then at the end of a certain period, we make a list of these people who want a change in the leadership of the pensioners and retirees. That too failed miserably, okay? And people, I think they are scared, the people are worried, and everybody's afraid, scared stiff, okay, and a lot of things to say. Anyway, me, I'm a person who is not really keen to fight for this position, honestly speaking. People who know me, I speak from my heart, okay. Ala kul hal, you know, this really disappointed me. Why people are approaching me, they won't change. I'm a reluctant partner for this change, because I don't want to get involved in these things, in this the petty, dirty politics. But anyway, I had volunteered because I did not want the monies to be divided into groups. That was my main concern. I was looking at it on a national level, that monies should not be separated between those who are getting low salaries and those who are getting high salaries. Okay, that was my message and my theme. And I stood up and I said, okay, I will try to see what we can do. I know that the situation is grim, it is very tight, very difficult, and I know very well that for us to get even some increase, we have to be grateful. But at the same time, the communication to people needs to be respectful. People need to be appreciated, and their contribution need to be appreciated. Unfortunately, Mr. Raul Rastoki, with due respects to you, when you made your final speech to PDO, you did not even mention the contribution of the pensioners and the retirees. That too hurt people a lot. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Ma'asalam.